Rich here from the rcnetwork.com, and today we're taking a look at the second episode of my Axial 1.9 Wraith build. Now, if you haven't already done so, please check out my first video on my 1.9 Wraith. It goes over all of the different parts that I kind of want to put on this thing to make my own build. And in this episode, we'll be going over everything thus far I've installed on my 1.9 Wraith and some things that have changed throughout the process. Also, throughout this video, I'll be asking you, the audience, some of your thoughts on some changes I want to make or some options that I have to make this thing even better. But I definitely need to hear from you guys. So some of the biggest changes on this episode has to do with the center transmission, motor mount, and also the ESC is mounted. And of course, all of the drive lines. So the rear axle, the rear suspension, the links, the drive line, and then everything on the front as well. Starting with the transmission, this thing was actually pretty cool to build. I've built a ton of three-gear transmissions from Axial, but it was really nice to just add all of the cool Vanquish parts and some incision parts as well. So this thing went together very nicely. I used all of those Avid bearings I mentioned in the first video. They fit on great and will give me a little bit more longevity with some of these upgraded Revolution bearings. Now, I did have to use a couple of parts from the stock transmission, like the spur gear and slipper clutch, but I was able to use that top shaft I mentioned in the first video. That thing fit on here perfectly and was an ease to assemble. I mounted up the Hobbywing Z-Run 3100 kV motor. Now this is the 540 size, so I think the technical number is 3652 is what they call it. Now being that it's a 3100, I'll be able to run this thing on 3S pretty easily. And it mounted in there pretty nicely. It didn't get in the way of any of the links or the link mounts at all. It was perfect clearance for this 540 size brushless censored motor. One thing really nice on the 1.9 Wraith is the ESC plate. It's actually removable. You notice that I've already mounted the ESC in there, but I can just take two screws off from the bottom and easily remove the ESC so I can solder up all of my wires and then just solder it up to the motor. Also, you may note that I removed the fan on this build. I don't think I'll need it. I'll watch my temperatures on the first few runs to see if I do need the fan, but there's plenty of room otherwise. Starting with the rear axle, it's always a pleasure to build anything from Vanquish products, especially their axle housings. Now the rear F9 axle housing for the SCX10-2 and 1.9 Wraith is very easy to assemble. Now everything loads into the third member right here, and then that all loads into the axle housing. It's a pretty easy assembly process, and everything that I chose for the build mounted up quite nicely. Now I did choose to run some of Axial's gears, that's their upgraded gears. I didn't go with overdrive initially just because I want to run it as a faster vehicle initially, and then we'll get into some crawling down the line. Moving on to the incision links, these things are quite nice, very heavy. They're made of stainless steel, so being heavy down low on the car is a good thing in this case. Now they all came with Traxxas Revo rod ends and those steel pivot ball inserts, so these are definitely a top of the line product, and they mounted up quite nicely in the 12.0 wheelbase version that I chose. They're also available in a 12.3 for most Axial vehicles. 1.9 Wraith is a 12-inch wheelbase vehicle, and that's what I'm going to keep it at for now. The front curry axle from Vanquish products, also very nice. Very similar to the rear as it loads everything into the third member and then into the axle housing. So it's very a modular unit. I did choose to add the incision universal drive shafts to the front, and those added in quite nicely as well. Now finally, these blue anodized SCX10-2 Vanquish knuckles, also a very nice design. They have a double shear post right here with the included spacer on the driver's side, and then on the flip side, it does have the dual mounting position for the two different links. I did add some of these Vanquish 12 millimeter hexes. These things just fit the build, and they were actually from a previous build I had, and I had these left over. So these added on quite nicely, and it was something I already had, so no additional money added to the build, and that's a good thing. Checking out the undercarriage, you can definitely see the MIP driveline. These things are also a pleasure to build, and they bolted up perfectly. Now, one thing about the SCX10-2 is the gear and pinion inside of the differentials. Now, if you rotate it one way, it's perfectly fine, but if you rotate the other way, the actual pinion gets sucked in. And what's nice about the MIP driveline is it actually includes a collar on the actual outdrive right here, and that prevents that pinion from diving into the third member. And this thing is perfectly set up now and very, very smooth. Now, diving deep inside, you can see the chassis mounted servo. I opted for something a little bit different than I normally run. This is an AGF servo, and the model number is A80BHMW. This is a 40 kilogram servo. It's brushless, it is high voltage, and it has an all aluminum shell, which is pretty nice. Now, I did make a mistake in the original video. I think it said it was about a 400 ounce inch torque motor. This thing actually cranks in, if you do the math of it, it's about 542 ounce inches. So this thing should have plenty of power for this 1/9 Wraith. Now, one of the coolest new products I installed were these new ProLine big bore scalar shocks. Now, these are just standard 90 to 95 millimeter shocks, and they are huge compared to the original scalar shocks, meaning they have a lot more internal capacity for fluid, so your dampening is going to be a lot better on these particular shocks. I did opt for those different spring rates. The scalar shocks come with a medium weight, but I opted for the tuning kit, which comes with a very lightweight and then a very heavyweight version. So right now I have the heavyweights on here on the rear, and they're quite nice, and I think this would be good for like a faster vehicle. Now, for crawling, the medium weight is going to be ideal. I have those installed on the front just so I can kind of compare the two and then finally decide down the line which ones I want to run for the first few videos. Now, one thing that you may have caught in the opening scene of this video was I went ahead and did the fastback mod to this 1/9 Wraith. Now, typically the Wraith has this kind of station wagon look to it where it just looks like an SUV or a station wagon. I've never liked that, even all the way back to my 2.2 Wraith I had probably nearly 10 years ago. I did a fastback mod on that with some brass tubing and really got creative on making the bends and really doing it right. Well, on this one, I just did the cheap free mod by using some of the links that was on the kit. This is actually one of the rear links, and it fits on there quite nice. Now, the way I did it was I basically just was brute force and clipped this entire section off with just some wire cutters. It came off pretty clean. And then I just used a sharp hobby knife to just trim it down and get it all flush and looking good. And then I just took a Dremel with a small drum sander and just made everything perfect to the end. And then mounting up these different links right here, I was going to chop off some of the section right here to make it all perfect, but I didn't need to do that. I just went ahead and bolted it straight up. Use a little bit longer screw right here by maybe 3-4 millimeters in length longer. And you'll have to remember that the roof line of the roof is going to actually cover this just a little bit. So I'll probably extend the roof down just to where it descends on these back bars and just covers up all the ugly here. And finally, that brings me to a whole series of questions I want to ask you guys for your opinion on. First off is the body. I went ahead and trimmed out the body here, and I've got to say it's a great body, but should I run this body or should I make aluminum panels for this build? Now, I've made aluminum panels for numerous builds all the way back to my 2.2 Wraith nearly 10 years ago. I also built them for my Axial Yeti, my Lozi Rock Ray, and of course the Techno DB48, but these are pretty simple to make, and it looks like just this triangle right here that would extend across and possibly up to this last little notch right here, but I can just leave it off and just kind of extend it to this point. So just a small little section here, a hood section, a roof section, and I'm basically done. But what do you guys think? Body or panels? What would you guys like to see? Next question are inner fenders. Now, I really like the fact that, you know, all the way back to the Bomber, this one right here, and even the Capra, they actually use these kind of half inner fenders. But I was thinking about actually covering up the rest of this here. Whether I do the body or the panels, it doesn't really matter. But I may still make them out of that aluminum, the 0.025 aluminum. But what do you guys think? Inner fenders or no inner fenders? What's your thoughts? And my last question for you guys, do you want to see this built as a crawler or a slow vehicle or actually a fast kind of U4RC type rig? Love to hear your thoughts down in the comment section. I think I've geared it and also powered it appropriately for either category, so it'll be pretty easy to just tune up the suspension different, maybe use some different foams in the tires and have this thing ready for either category. But once again, what do you guys think I should do? Well, guys, that is episode 2 of my 1.9 Wraith build. Can't wait to actually get this thing finished and out on the trail or on the rocks. We'll have to see what you guys decide. But with that, in the next episode, hopefully I'll have the body done. So vote for panels or body down in the comments section. I'll have everything wired up and possibly show you guys that wheel and tire combo. It is amazing. It's sitting right off to the left of the camera right now, but you'll have to wait and see that in the third episode. As always, if you like the video, hit the like button. It gets it out to more and more people out there. If you haven't already done so, please subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell so you'll be notified every time I upload a video. And finally, my name is Rich. Thanks for watching. Let's go.